Hello everyone, I'm Professor Sasengjin of GSTE, Grandmaster Small Talk on English, the Global Language. Whether you are a Christian or not, you may be interested in reading the English Bible. But because of difficult vocabularies or complicated grammatical structures, you may have given up. Yes, no more reading. But these days, there are several books written in easy English on the Bible, so-called paraphrased collections of interesting stories from Old and New Testament. Based on these materials, will you journey into the English Bible with me? Let's start with Genesis. The first part of the Old Testament. Let me read the phrase first. In the beginning, God made the heavens and the earth. All was dark and empty. So God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. He called the light day, and the darkness night. And that was the first day. Then God said, "Let there be bodies of water, and above them a sky." And it was so. That was the second day. Now, let me tell you in detail about this first and second day creation of God. At first, in the beginning, God created two things. One, the land, the earth. The other is the heavens. Now, let me tell you the difference between a sky and a heaven. A sky is a physical space where we can see clouds flow and airplanes fly. But a heaven is a spiritual space where God rules. It is said that there are layers in heaven, so it is expressed in plural form, heavens. God created two things. One, the earth, the land, and the other, the heavens. But there was nothing there. All was dark and empty. Have you ever experienced such things like this? Darkness and emptiness? As if you were in a tunnel. If you are in a tunnel, you may be very afraid and you want to get out of this place. How? By finding the exit where the light comes in. So God said, "Let there be light." He ordered the light be there, and there was light. Whatever God says, it is done, it is realized. That's the power of God's word. And God called the light day, and He called the darkness night, so we can have days and nights. That was the first day of His creation. Then God said again, "Let there be bodies of water, and above them a sky." Here, can you understand the phrase bodies of water? Bodies of water means collection of waters, just like lakes or seas. God asks, God orders waters be there, here and there as a collection of waters, such as seas and lakes. And above them, God also ordered the sky be there. And it was so. Whatever God says, it is realized, it is done. That was the second day of his creation. Now, let me read one more time. If you want, you can follow me. In the beginning, God made the heavens and the earth. All was dark and empty. So God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. He called the light day and the darkness night. And that was the first day. Then God said, "Let there be bodies of water, and above them a sky." And it was so. That was the second day. Now, let me tell you one sentence relating to the vocabulary call. Do you understand this phrase? Let's call it a day. One more time. Let's call it a day. This means that because you have worked all day very hard, let's stop here. Let's decide not to work anymore. It's enough for today. Whether it is a work or a study, whatsoever, let's stop because you have done enough. So, how about this? Let's call it a day. You can use this phrase in your daily life. That's the whole story we can cover today. See you next time, starting with Genesis, the third day creation of God. I'm Professor Sa Seung-jin of GSTE, Grandma's Small Talk on English, the Global Language.